Hello everyone, thanks for participating in this activity. Finally, today we will cover sperm swarm optimizer, and as you can see here, this optimizer is introduced in year 2018, and we can use this optimizer to solve different optimization problems. And like you can see here, this is applied to solve wireless sensor network challenges. This optimizer is straightforward and computationally efficient, so we can solve different complex optimization problems using this optimizer. And this is also tested on different benchmark test functions, also compared with well-known optimization algorithms. And the main inspiration you can see here, this optimizer is inspired by the natural fertilization process of sperms competing to fertilize an egg. And first we will start with natural fertilization process in humans. As you can see, the main inspiration, we have the natural fertilization process. So first we will start with natural fertilization process in humans, so that we can easily understand how this optimizer is designed and applied to solve optimization problems. So step by step, we will cover everything from fertilization process to how this optimizer simulates this process to solve optimization problems. Now let's start it. So first we will discuss fertilization process in humans, so that we can easily understand how this algorithm is working, how fertilization process is simulated in this optimizer, how different mathematical models are designed to simulate fertilization process. Then step by step we will discuss its working using different examples. First we will start with what is fertilization process. In simple words, a sperm cell fusing with an egg cell to create a zygote is known as fertilization. Now we will understand this process in detail, because this is the algorithm main inspiration. Now we have fertilization process in humans. This is the first step in the creation of a new life, where male sperm meets the female egg to form a baby. It all begins when a single egg and lucky sperm comes together and starting the creation of new life. Millions of sperm race to find it. Only one lucky sperm successfully reaches and fertilizes the egg. New life begins as a tiny zygote, which grows and develops over time. Now first we will understand from where this egg comes from and how sperm know the egg location. So here you can see females have two ovaries, but only one egg is released each month during ovulation. And it's not always the same ovary. Each month one of them releases an egg. And this egg travels down the fallopian tube, where it may meet the sperm. If the sexual intercourse happens, females are born with all the eggs they will ever have, and number of eggs varies from female to female, and they lose over time through natural processes. Now we have this egg. If this egg is not fertilized, the lining sets and periods start. This setting of uterine lining causes periods in female, because lining is made of blood tissues. So when egg is not fertilized, it breaks down and blood with some tissues is released as menstrual blood. Now second case, when the egg is fertilized, it creates new life. Now here question is, how sperm know egg's location? Millions of sperm released, but only one lucky winner that successfully fertilized the egg, and we have only one winner. So what happens to all the sperms that does not reach the egg? During sexual intercourse, millions of sperms are released into female's vagina, and from vagina sperm swims through the cervix and into the uterus. Sperm does not know where the egg is, but body use chemicals to guide them. Egg release specific chemicals into the surrounding area to attract sperm, guiding to the correct location. This is called chemotaxis. Only one lucky sperm reaches the egg and fertilizes it, because female reproductive system is challenging place for the sperm. Only few strong and healthy sperm will reach the fallopian tube. Most sperm die or get trapped in the cervix, uterus. They don't have energy or right direction to find the egg, because vagina pH level and temperature also play major role in the survival of sperm. So vagina pH is natural acidic, around 4 to 5. The pH level can affect sperm motility and viability. This acidic environment can be harmful to sperm, so sperm may not survive long in the vaginal canal. When ovulation occurs, mucus around the cervix becomes thinner, clear and more alkaline, which is more friendly for sperm, which protects sperm from acidic environment of vagina and allowing them to move easily through the cervix towards egg. This seminal fluid has a slightly alkaline pH around 7.2 to 8 that protect the sperm from this acidic environment and allow them to move easily. Second main factor we have here, temperature. Sperm ability to survive and swim decreases if the temperature becomes too high. Overheating inside and outside body can reduce sperm count, mobility, and overall fertility. The temperature of female reproductive tract during ovulation is ideal for the sperm to travel and fertilize egg. So here both pH and temperature are essential factor for sperm health and fertility. If either factor is off, it can reduce the chances of fertilization. And if the egg is not fertilized by sperm within 12 to 24 hours of ovulation, it cannot develop into a zygote. It breaks down and body naturally absorbs the tissues. Second case we have here, once the egg reaches the egg in the fallopian tube, it tries to enter the egg and the egg's outer layer is tough, but sperm release special enzyme to break through. And once sperm get in, the egg's membrane change to make sure no other sperm can enter. This is when fertilization happens. The sperm and egg combine the genetic material to form a single cell that is called zygote. They combine their genetic codes. This is the first step in creating new life. After fertilization, zygote begins dividing into smaller cells in a process called cleavage. These divisions keep happening until the zygote turns into a ball of cells known as blastocyst. Blastocyst then travels to the uterus and buries itself in the thick lining of uterus in a process called implantation. This is where the embryo starts to grow and the pregnancy officially begins. It is beautiful and complex process leading to the creation of every human beings. We all are special and unique, starting from the very first moment of fertilization. Now we will understand how this natural fertilization process is simulated in this optimizer to solve optimization problems. So this we will try to understand by a comparison. On one side we have natural fertilization process and other side we have sperm swarm optimizer. So first point we have, in natural fertilization, sperm start at random position in search space, and here female reproductive system is the search space. And in this optimizer, each sperm is a candidate solution of the problem that we are trying to solve, and we will randomly initialize n number of sperms within the multidimensional search space. Second point, in natural fertilization, sperm swims toward the egg using temperature and chemical signals, as we discussed early. Environmental conditions such as pH and temperature, they play major role in the survival of each sperm. And in natural fertilization, each sperm fitness is determined by how close it is to the egg. In this optimizer, solution will move toward optimal areas based on their personal best position and global best position. In this optimizer, we will update sperm velocity using environmental factors like pH and temperature, and we will use problem specific fitness function to evaluate how good or bad solution is, means how close or far it is to the optimal solution. Third point, in natural fertilization, each sperm remember the best position it has searched in the past. In this optimizer, each candidate will update its personal best position. If current best position has better fitness score, then we will update. So we are maintaining her personal best for each search agent. And in this optimizer, best solution will guide other candidates towards the optimal point. Fourth point we have, in natural fertilization, sperms are influenced by the best sperm that is near to the egg. It is influencing the movement of other. In this optimizer, we will adjust velocity and position based on global best position. Global best position, that is best position among all. Next point, in natural fertilization process, sperm adjust their velocity based on their current speed, distance from the egg, and environmental influences like pH, temperature. So here, sperm group together swims more efficiently towards the egg. In this optimizer, we are using different mathematical models to simulate this behavior and move all the candidates in the search space. Next point, in natural fertilization, first sperm to reach the egg is the winner. In this optimizer, sperm will perform exploration and exploitation in the solution space collectively, and algorithm identify the best solution among all as the winner. Last point, in natural fertilization process, membrane blocks other sperm once the egg is fertilized. In this optimizer, algorithm will stop when the best solution is found or maximum number of iteration reached. Now, step by step, we will understand this optimizer working using different examples. First step, we will initialize all the important parameters like population size, that is total number of sperms, maximum number of iteration means how many times the loop will repeat, and after that it will display the best solution. Objective function, so we will define problem specific objective function, dimension, mutation rate and all. Next step, we will initialize the position for all sperm. So first we will randomly initialize a population of n sperm cells within the boundaries of solution space. So here we have sperm cells as the candidate solutions and each represented as a vector in solution space. You can see here in this optimizer, each sperm is represented as a point in multidimensional search space. Next step, evaluate fitness score for all. So sperm work together to find the best solution, that is egg. So here we will consider their personal best position and a global best position. Here we have personal best position. Here each candidate fitness score is their personal best score, and we will update this if new score is better. Then we will assign new score as the personal best score. After this we have global best, that is best among all. So we will choose the best fitness score among all as the global best solution, that is the winner sperm. So this is the best solution found by entire swarm. So here we will evaluate each sperm cell's position using fitness function. So fitness function we are using here to measure how close the solution is to the optimal solution. After this we will update each sperm position. So each sperm position is adjusted based on its current velocity and its personal best and global best position. For all sperm in the current population, we will update their position. Now we will move all sperms towards egg. So first we will calculate velocity for all. They will swim using velocity update rule. Here velocity change depending on the factors like sperm on previous speed, the distance to its personal best and global best position, environmental conditions like pH and temperature, which add random variations. So we will update the velocity for each sperm using this equation. Here I is the number of sperm is equal to initial velocity plus current best solution plus global best solution. Now one by one we will calculate initial velocity, current best solution and global best solution. Initial velocity we will calculate using this equation. Here capital D is the factor of damping velocity, that is a random value between 0 and 1. So randomly we will choose a value between 0 and 1. This factor is used to adjust the velocity of sperm. Next we have VI, that is the sperm velocity. After this we have pH value. You can see this is pH value, and we will take this value randomly in the range 7 to 14. Next we will calculate current best solution, the personal best solution, and it is obtained by the sperm itself, and it is obtained by comparing past location of sperm with its current location, and this location will be stored in the memory for comparison. If the past location is better than the new one or not, then we have pH level. The value we will take for this randomly between 7 to 14, that is alkaline. After this we have temperature value. This is used to simulate the temperature of visited area, and value we will choose randomly between range 35.1 to 35.8. After this we have sperm best position minus its current position. After this we will calculate global best position using this equation. Here we have pH range 7 to 14, we will randomly choose this value. Then we have temperature value that we will randomly take between 35.1 to 38.5, and this is we have swarm global best solution minus current best solution. After velocity calculation we will update the final position using this equation. In the previous position we will add the calculated velocity. After velocity update we will perform mutation. So here population is divided into three groups for varieties. We have non-uniform mutation, uniform mutation and no mutation. Non-uniform mutation adds small uneven changes to the sperm position, uniform mutation and even changes to the sperm position, and no mutation keeps the sperm position unchanged. So this ensures the diversity in sperm and improve convergence. So why mutation is introduced? To increase diversity and prevent algorithm from getting stuck in the local optima. Non-uniform mutation apply uneven changes, excluding the local areas. Uniform mutation apply even changes, that is balancing the exploration and exploitation phases. Then we have no mutation. This is used to preserve the solution. So this is a simple and straightforward optimizer. First, we will initialize all the important parameters. After this, we will initialize the position for all search agents. Then we will evaluate their fitness score, compare their fitness values and choose best among all, that is the global best. After this, we will calculate the velocity and update position for all. And then we will perform mutation. We will repeat this loop until the stopping condition is met. And once the stopping condition is met, we will stop and display the best solution that is found in the last iteration. So that's all about this video. If you have any questions, you can comment below. And thanks for watching this video.